हेलो एवरीवन, वेल टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट पंजाबी कुजीन। वेल दिस कुजीन इज वेरी पॉपुलर नॉट ओनली इन इंडिया बट अराउंड द वर्ल्ड। इफ यू विजिट एनी पार्ट ऑफ इंडिया यू कैन फाइंड ए पंजाबी ढाबा, एंड इफ यू आर प्लानिंग टू विजिट एनी अदर कंट्री ऑफ द वर्ल्ड ऑल्सो देन ऑल्सो यू कैन फाइंड ए पंजाबी ढाबा, विच इंडिकेट्स द पॉपुलरिटी ऑफ दिस कुजीन। सो टुडे इन दिस वीडियो वील स्टडी अबाउट दिस कुजीन इन डिटेल। फर्स्ट वील टॉक अबाउट द हिस्ट्री एंड ज्योग्राफी of this region, then we'll talk about the silent feature of Punjabi cuisine, then we'll study about the signature dishes from this region, the herbs and spices which are used in Punjabi cuisine, then at last we'll talk about the festival from this region, and I will also tell you about the menu, breakfast menu and lunch menu which can be planned from this cuisine. So this video will be very useful to you if you watch it carefully. Now first we'll talk about the location. Well, all of you know that Punjab is a state in northern India, forming part of the largest Punjab region of the Indian subcontinent. The state is bordered by the Indian states of Himachal Pradesh to the north and northeast, Haryana to the south and southeast, and Rajasthan to the southwest. And Chandigarh is the capital of this state. And this state has got fertile land, and that is why agriculture is the largest industry in Punjab. And Punjab is also called the wheat bowl of India, because Punjab almost feeds half of our country. Half of the wheat is grown over here only. Now, history and geography. Well, the word Punjab is made up of two Persian words. Panj means five and Ab means water, as the five rivers Jhelum, Chenab, Ravi, Bis and Satluj flow through this region. Punjab emerges into history with the coming of Aryans into India. Then came the Muslims invaders from Persia and Afghan. And during this period, the Punjabi cuisine was also invaded and the tandoor came into use in Punjabi cuisine. Well, after the partition, the Punjab was divided into two, East and West. West went to Pakistan. And after the partition, these Punjabi people, they came and they settled around Delhi. And they spread across northern states, and the cuisine was also spread across northern states. And this is how the cuisine became popular. Now, when we talk about the silent features of this cuisine, well, people of Punjab are both vegetarian and non-vegetarian. So you can find varieties of non-vegetarian dishes from this region and varieties of vegetarian dishes, which later we'll talk in detail when we'll study about the menu from this region. People prefer both home cooked food and they also prefer to go to restaurant, because there are many Punjabi dhaba available, especially in northern India. You can find them everywhere. So people loves to go out also, and they make the food at home also. Besides this, the varieties of pickles are consumed, like carrot pickle, band gobi pickle, turnip pickle. The reason is because vegetables are available in abundance. The winter vegetables include radish, then turnip, methi, palak, band gobi, carrot, mutter, etc. And during summer also you can find the market is flooded with brinjal, bitter gourd, lauki, kaddu, etc. Wheat is the staple diet from this region. Rice is used for festivals only, and occasionally people make rice. Different pulses are grown and people love to eat pulses. Tandoori cookery is very famous. Later on we'll study about it in detail. And people eat lots of milk and milk products also. Now coming on to the breads. Well, Punjabi people are fond of breads, because as I said, they make rice very occasionally, and generally during festival only they make rice. Otherwise people from this region eat only breads. And they eat both type of bread, leavened bread and unleavened bread. Leavened means in which there is yeast or any other raising agent. Unleavened means without any yeast or without any raising agents. And the best one example is kulcha. Well, Amritsari kulcha is very famous. So it is prepared from flour, which is rolled into round shape, and then it is cooked. Second famous bread from this region is bhatura. So bhaturas are prepared from refined flour. Bhaturas and puris are quite similar, but there are some differences also. Like puri is smaller in size, bhatura is bigger in size. Puri is made up of wheat flour, bhatura is made up of refined flour. Bhatura dough is leavened, that means it is raised. Sometimes it is prepared overnight also. Then makki ki roti, it is a flat unleavened bread prepared from corn flour. And all of you must have heard about makki ki roti and sarso ka saag. So it is best enjoyed with sarso ka saag. Now coming on to the tandoor. Well, the Punjabi tandoor from South Asia is traditionally made up of clay and is a bell-shaped oven which can either be set into the earth and fired with wood or charcoal, and it reaches the temperature of around 480 degrees Celsius. And tandoori cooking is a traditional aspect of Punjabi cuisine. In India, especially in Punjab, especially in the villages, you can find communal tandoor also, where the people use a single tandoor for making different breads and all. Especially in villages, communal tandoors are still exist in remote areas of Punjab. So different dishes are prepared in tandoor, like tandoori chicken. All of you must have heard about this dish, very famous dish. Chicken tikka, which is boneless chicken. It is marinated in tandoori masala, and then it is also enjoyed as an appetizer. Then tandoori naan, it is a flat bread made from refined flour. Yeast is used as leavening agent. In some recipes you can find curd and sugar is used. In some recipe you can find yeast is used. So yeast is generally used to raise the dough, but if you are making the dough overnight, then there is no need to use yeast. Directly also you can make the dough. Now paratha, well, varieties of parathas are consumed by Punjabi people, especially during the breakfast. And the reason is that availability of vegetables. Different types of vegetables, fresh vegetables are available, especially during winter season. So people make varieties of stuffed paratha and they enjoy it in the breakfast. Aloo paratha, gobi paratha, mooli paratha, the list is endless. You can find varieties of them. Then halwa puri, they eat it all the times. And especially in the remote area, you can find the people make halwa puri during festivals and occasion. If there is any festival, they will always make halwa puri. That is a tradition in Punjab. Then faluda, it is a beverage, and traditionally it is made by mixing rose syrup, vermicelli, basil seeds and tapioca pearls along with milk, or ice cream is also used these days. Then lassi, people are very much fond of lassi from this region, and some people, especially in village, they start the day with lassi only. For some people, the breakfast is only lassi. They will drink around half liter or 1 liter of lassi, and that will be like breakfast for them. Especially the farmers of Punjab, they will have lassi and they will go to the field. Then meat dishes, tandoori chicken, very popular dish, and it consists of roasted chicken that is prepared with yogurt and other spices. The name comes from the tandoor itself, and the chicken is cooked inside this oven. That is why it is called tandoori chicken. Then butter chicken, this dish again you can find around the world. The dish is prepared in makhani gravy. It is a yogurt based gravy, and later on it is finished with butter. Traditionally the chicken is cooked in tandoor first, and then half cooking take place in the gravy. Chicken tikka, these are small pieces of boneless chicken which are baked using skewers in a oven which is called tandoor. Tandoor is actually Indian oven. So these boneless pieces are marinated. Sometimes these pieces are left in the marination for around 4 to 6 hours. And then they are put inside the skewers and then baked inside the oven. And the basting is also done at regular intervals. Basting means applying oil. So instead of oil, Punjabi people use ghee, that is clarified butter. Well, keema, it is a traditional South Asian meat dish. Actually, it means minced meat. In Punjab, people use keema for making different types of snacks like samosa. Even they stuff the naan with keema these days. Like you can find keema naan also. And keema is also used for making kebabs. Then Amritsari machli. Well, this fish is prepared from gram flour batter. And the marination is done twice. That is the speciality of this dish. Well, sarso ka saag. Well, in this dish, the main ingredients are mustard leaves, garlic and spinach. And it is accompanied with makki ki roti. Very famous dish, especially people enjoy it during winter season. Because in winter season, mustard and spinach are available in plenty. People make sarso ka saag daily. Especially in villages, they make this dish daily. Then dal makhani. Well, it is a dish which was originated in Delhi. Because these Punjabi people, they came to Delhi. And urad dal is used along with kidney beans for making this dish. Then shahi paneer. Well, this dish is prepared in a thick gravy. And this gravy is white in color. So onion, cream, khaskhas, which is poppy seed, curd, and all the flavorful spices are used for making shahi gravy. And turmeric or other colorful spices are avoided. Because the color is white, that is why we avoid the colorful spices. So only the flavorful spices and whole garam spices are used. Now coming on to the sweet. Well, kheer, it is a rice pudding. And it is the signature dish of this region. And people from this region, they make kheer on different occasion also. During festivals also, they make kheer. And this kheer is flavored with cardamom. And different types of dry fruits are also used. And it is typically served during a meal or also consumed alone as a dessert. People of Punjab are so much fond of kheer that they don't eat any other thing. They enjoy only kheer as a meal, especially in villages, farmers. Well, jalebi. Well, in India, jalebi is served as the celebration sweet of India. Popular during national holidays like Independence Day and Republic Day, you can find colorful jalebis which are prepared from different colors. So this jalebi is served warm along with rabdi. Rabdi is served as an accompaniment for jalebi. And the batter is prepared overnight and then deep fried. Just given the spiral shape and deep fried, and it is dipped in the sugar syrup. Now coming on to the spices, asafoetida. Well, this spices has got some medicinal properties also. If you have any stomach problem or gas problem, you can use this spice. Very good for health. And it also gives good flavor to the dish. Turmeric, well, it gives yellow color and it has got anti-inflammatory and antiseptic property also. That is why we always marinate the fish with salt and turmeric. Because turmeric is antiseptic. It's prevent the growth of bacteria. And that is why in Indian cuisine, we always use turmeric. Like in Conti, we use vinegar. Same way in Indian food, we use turmeric. Fenugreek, well, it is a common spice which is used in Punjabi cuisine. This spice is grown in East India and in southern part also, in Kerala, etc. you can find. And this spice has got bitter taste. Then amchur, it is actually mango powder. And it gives sour taste to the dish. In some dishes, instead of tomato, people add amchur, and it gives sourness to the dish. Beside this, there are many other spices which are very common to Punjabi cuisine. That is coriander seeds, till seeds. Till seeds are not that much used in abundance, generally used in some dishes. Ginger, garlic is always used. mint leaves used for garnishing, fenugreek, cumin, saffron, kalonji, ajwain. So these are some of the spices which you can find in Punjabi cuisine, and they are almost used in most of the dishes. Now coming on to the festivals that are celebrated in this region. Well, there are different types of festivals like Guru Purab, which is celebrated on the full moon of Kartik, the birth anniversary of Guru Nanak. Then Dashera, it is the most popular festival, not only in, it is celebrated in Punjab but across North India. Then Rakhi, Rakhi festival is very popular. On this day, sister tie the multicolored thread on the right wrist of their brothers. Beside this, Baishakhi, during this festival, Punjabi people make kheer, malpua, churma, Guru Nanak Jayanti, Holi, Lohri. During Lohri, the Punjabi people make rodi kheer, that means sugar cane juice kheer, akhrot ki kheer, then Karwa Chauth. So these are some of the famous festival of this region. So well, this is all about Punjabi cuisine. I will come again with another video. Till the time, all of you, take care. Bye-bye.